Hello, I'm Reverend Sam, and I'm your regular host on Power Encounter TV broadcast. I pray for you today that the mountaintop experience will be your testimony. Jesus took Peter, James, and John to the mountain of transfiguration, and the Bible said that he was transfigured before them. It's not his transfiguration so that matter really, that one has been predestined, but their eyes were open to see. I pray that in the name of Jesus, that the glory of God that God has given to me for ministry and for this ministration, that your eyes will be open to see in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible says, as we behold the glory, we become like the glory. I pray that your eyes will be open to see the glory of the gospel today. And as you see it, you will enter into it and become partaker of it. In the mighty name of Jesus. I see, as it were, dirty water is being taken away, and I see fresh water coming in. I command that in the name of Jesus. Whoever is watching me right now, and your life is a form of that dirty water, I pray that grace of God for revival will enter into your life, and that there shall be transformation in you this day, that make it to be on fire for God, and begin to do the will of God. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And amen. I want to share with you from the book of Luke chapter 10. In the book of Luke chapter 9, Jesus sent out 12 and gave them power and authority, like I said in last episode. When they came back, the Bible said in chapter 10 that Jesus sent another 70 and sent them out again. And he told them, just go everywhere to preach the gospel, heal the sick, cast out devils, whatever they give you, take it in the name of the Lord. And the Bible says in verse 17, the 72 returned with joy. There's no way you will go out and you won't return with joy. Now, what does it mean to go out? What it means to go out is you begin to do what the word of God commands you to do. Somebody's going out might be to set up an orphanage. Another person's going out might be to begin to give money to support the work of God. Somebody else will be God want to begin to go out and encourage people. It can be on the phone. You can do it via Skype, via social media. That may be God's way of sending you out. The point is, you've got to discover how you were sent out. Have you ever wondered why, after you gave your life to Jesus, he didn't just kill you and take you to heaven? Have you ever wondered why? You know why? Because he wants to use you to reach other people who were like you before you gave your life to Jesus. Each one of us have an audience, a set of people that God has anointed us to also reach and bring into salvation. I remember a group of friends of mine that we formed Immaculate Club of Lagos together many, many years ago. When I gave my life to Christ, all of them were making jest of me because I was the prominent and the most outstanding among all of them. And then they said, Samuel, whoa, whoa. We give you 3 months, you are coming back. And I said in my heart, I said, Lord, I pray for these people. I pray that I will not come back to them. They will be the one to come back to me. I'm glad to let you know that at least one or two of them now are pastors. They don't only come into salvation, they came and began to work for God. What is it that God asks you to do? As a married woman, your first ministry is towards your husband and your children. Are you doing it well? Are you a role model to other women? Are you a role model to your children? Because you see, when we say Jesus sent them out, you've got to understand that we are sent to different people. You might be sent to just one person, that place of work. It might be that person that God has sent you to, so that you can influence the life of that person. You remember one time when Jesus Christ was standing by the well? He was standing by the well for hours, and all he was doing was to minister to one woman who has had 5 failed marriages. You remember when Jesus went to the pool of Bethsaida? He went there, and despite all the people that are sick there, he went there and he healed that man that had been down there for 38 years. He healed that man and turned his back and went out of that place. What am I trying to say? Number one, you've got to discover to whom you are sent. I am not sent to everybody. I'm not the only anointed man of God, but I know I am sent to people in Houston. I am the light of the world, and the thing darkness cover Houston. And I know, because I am here, God even said it to me, that as I keep preaching the gospel to you, life will come to you. You know, many years ago, one of my prophet friends had this vision. When I first started ministry, almost 30 years ago, he said he saw me standing by a graveyard. He said he just saw that I began to talk. At first, nothing was happening. But after a while, dead people started rising from their grave and they began to come together. And their frame, the way they look, began to change gradually. And all of them became living soul. And you know, when he said it that time, I didn't really understand much. But now I know that God has given me an anointing to speak and transform lives by the grace of God that he has given to me to preach. And so if you are watching me, it means I am one of those that God has sent into your life. You've got to find out who you are sent to, so that number one, you can be useful to God. Number two, he can serve as a preservation for your life and your family. And number three, it can be a point of contact for you to be qualified for a reward. Because anyone that does not do anything is not qualified to be rewarded. Let's go to verse 18. The Bible says, Jesus, he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Verse 9, behold, I have given unto you authority to tread on serpent and scorpion and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall by any means hurt you. I like that last phrase. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Why will Jesus give us authority to tread upon serpent and scorpion? You know why? Because there are serpent and scorpion that are coming towards us. Their intention is to harm us, but we have been given authority to tread on them. You can only tread on something that is coming to attack you. So when you see opposition of the kingdom of darkness, say to yourself, I have been anointed to tread upon them. Now the Bible says you have been anointed to tread upon serpent and scorpion. You know, serpent is the form of Satan. In the book of Genesis and in the book of Revelation, serpent is a type of Satan. Now, scorpions are demons. Those are things that are meant to harm you. But God said he has given you authority. Now, maybe we need to quickly look at that word authority. When you see a cop, a policeman, and he puts on his uniform and he asks a trailer to stop, a four-wheeler, he just says stop, the four-wheeler will stop, not because the policeman hat is hefty, but because he puts on a cloth that authorizes him. And you see, the authority that is upon that man is the authority of the government that give him the cloth. So if it's community police, it means the authority of the community officers is upon him. If it is state police, it means that the authority of the governor of the state is upon him. If it is federal police, that means that person has the authority of the federal government on him. And everybody respect and listen to him because of the authority conferred on him. Now listen, do you know that every child of God that has accepted to take up the responsibility of going, you have the authority of the God of heaven? You can imagine. He's the one that created heaven and the earth. In fact, the Bible says that God is the one that created Satan, demons, principalities, and powers. He created all of them for his own glory. And you know what gives God glory now? When you cast out devils, when you send the evil spirit out, When you heal the sick, you send the sicknesses out, that is when God receives glory now. So just like the federal policeman, we feel proud that if you touch him, you are touching the authority of the federal government. In the same way, anyone that tries to touch you is trying to touch the authority of the Almighty God. Do you see how great you are? But the problem is, many of us, we see ourselves as ordinary. And you know, confidence comes from within. Faith comes from within. That's why I'm saying these things to you, to let you know that as a child of God that has accepted the responsibility of going, what does that mean? You are carrying out an assignment. The going may be to stand by your pastor. The going may be to go for mission work. The going may be to sponsor charity work. The going may be to give money to those who are doing this work. Everyone that is doing what God wants you to do, you are one of those that are going. And Jesus said, Satan will always fall before you. Hallelujah. Now, and Jesus said to them, I give you authority to tread upon serpents, Satan, and demons, and over all the power of the enemy. You see, he gave you authority over the power of the enemy. So no matter the power that the enemy thinks they have, you know what? You are authorized to tread on them. You are authorized to make nothing of them. He gave them power. He gave them authority over all the power of the enemy. I like that. And nothing shall by any means hurt you. You are not expected to be hurt by satanic powers. I don't care what anybody tells you. It is not the will of God for you to be hurt by satanic powers. Yes, they will attack you, but the plan of God is that they will not succeed. Yes, they will come against you, but the plan of God is that their plan will not come to pass. The Bible says, no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. When I check the original meaning of that word prosper, it means no weapon formed or fashioned against you shall achieve the enemy's original intended plan. That means whatever the enemy planned to do in your life is not allowed to come to pass. If the enemy intends to disgrace you, God will disgrace the enemy. If the enemy wants to keep you down in sickness, God will set you free. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. But the key there is that it's a promise for those who open up their heart and accept the challenge of going forth. You know that Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all nations. Once you begin to do that, start with your family, then with your friends, and then begin to see this authority work in your life. I hereby pray for you today that in the name of Jesus, may the heavens be open over your head so that I can begin to operate in the authority of Christ in the name of Jesus. I pray may the eyes of your understanding begin to open up to see the power that you carry in the mighty name of Jesus. I command right now that every oppressor of your destiny, I give you grace from this moment to begin to oppress them in the name of Jesus Christ. I command that every spirit of oppression, every load, satanic load upon you, in pratasso kasi katula kabasondaba, I command them to be waved off, to be moved off your neck, to be moved off your shoulder. You are set free this day in the name of Jesus. The Lord has anointed me for the liberty of nations. I set you free in the name of Jesus. From every spirit of infirmity, I set you free in the name of Jesus. I feel like there's somebody you have something happening to your you step on something and it affected your leg. I command in the name of Jesus that you be made whole. That spirit of infirmity, I curse it in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever the enemy has done against your life, I undo it today. By the covenant of the blood, I undo it and I set you free in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that the Lord will touch your heart so that you begin to walk with him and serve him in spirit and in truth. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. I'm glad I'm able to bring this word to you. Let me know what God has done in your life, how this message has been a blessing to you. Send me text message. Just send me an email through the email address on the screen, and I'll make effort to get back to you. I want to join our Refiners Fire Prayer Network. It's a prayer network where we come together with one sole aim to rekindle the fire of God, the fire of revival in our heart. In these days, we have many Christians who have, you know, you carry the form of godliness, but there's no power. As you come together to pray with us, God will ignite his fire in you and you begin to fulfill your destiny in the name of Jesus. But you see, for the venue, because we moved the venue, from the venue and the date, it's always on Saturdays. One Saturday in a month. For the venue and the date, you have to send your name and your number to the number on the screen or the email on the screen, and then I will have to get back to you, or someone will get back to you to let you know where we're going to have the next one. I've got to go right now, but until I come here again next time, don't you ever forget that no matter what you have gone through in life, now that you're a child of God, I'm very, very sure that the testimony of your life will be that you are wonderful because Jesus is real. I'll see you next time. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Lord, you are great. Thunder announce your presence. The storm announce your power. I can't imagine your greatness.